Hey, listen, we know this is a shock to everybody.
Surprise!
We're not on.
We're on the camera.
But
surprise!
It's the YouTube pre-show. The YouTube pre-show. YouTube sees this first.
Pastor went to sleep again. Surprise!
Actually, both of you should maybe start with your head on the table, I think.
What are we doing with this?
This really hurts. I have so much sinus pressure.
What are we doing in a place like this?
He's gonna pick his head up and there's gonna be streams.
This
of
is gonna be our pre-show song.
What is this?
Oh my! What?
This is the beginning of Sweet Caroline.
Where it began.
Wait a second. Everlasting love.
So I'm going to play that as an outro. You're not going to hear it, though.
Little Neil Diamond this morning.
All right, going live.
I'm not going to believe it. I don't believe.
Surprise, everybody. Pastor doesn't even believe that we're on.
I don't believe it.
We're here.
I don't believe it.
It's Tuesday morning. Did I tell you it was Tuesday?
Yeah, there was such a tremendous outcry from our six fans.
An outpouring
that
of love.
We had to come and do the show.
Are we up to six fans now?
Already
great.
Six. So they're all relatives.
Yeah,
but
well, there's no question about that. Thank you, guys. So we're relatively popular.
Oh, gosh.
Two. We got two.
Oh, wow.
Two people are on here with us right
now.
Wow,
thank
you.
Hey, Kirkwood has been sick, but he says he's better. I think it's the three bottles of NyQuil.
I tell you what, I'm on everything. I went there. They gave me the antibiotics, right?
Oh, okay.
Antibiotics. You know, steroids. You know, prednisone and you know
got all of that?
Hydrocodone. A couple shots of those. Energy drinks. You thought I was going to say alcohol. I'm a Baptist.
No,
why are you looking at me?
You said oxycodone, so I was.
I said hydrocodone.
Oh, hydrocodone.
So
okay.
What do you got?
I don't
condone any of this talk about drugs.
Okay.
This is a terrible start. Should we start this over?
No. No. I don't even believe we're on the thing.
We've started it over three times now.
Are we on there
this
for
just,
real?
Just, I think so. The technology not working today. You know, I'm fine if the tech doesn't work today. You want to know why?
Why?
Because this past weekend it worked perfectly.
Did it?
It did. Everything was fine. Well, you know, the second service, the stream cut off at the end, but that's not a big deal. People should have been watching the first service anyway. Why did we even have a second service? Everybody went to go to their lunches and that sort of thing, right?
Well, you can't just, you know.
You know what one of my favorite
moments? Wave away the crowd that was here in the
I
second
know, I'm
service.
I'm just being silly. You know what I say to the choir almost every week, though, is that my favorite service is the 8 a.m. service.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because that's when we run everything ahead of time.
Yeah.
Just have a really good. There's usually like four or so people in there. But anyway. This past weekend was great, wasn't it? We didn't want to not have a recap.
It was.
We had
I know. It was a great Sunday. I was beat, man. I'm telling you, I was just whipped for the afternoon.
Well, you came into the pulpit, and you know, I said earlier, you came out throwing 101 miles an hour, like you were Nolan Ryan up there, just throwing the heat. I loved it. I was ready for it. I sat down. You were dropping bombs. The people were with you too.
You went
to amen yourself, and they wouldn't even let you.
Yeah,
do it.
I couldn't amen. I couldn't get my amen in fast enough. They beat me to the punch.
I can't remember the last time that's happened.
I can't either. Well, I hope it happens again.
So props, Valleydale. The culture is changing. We've got people amening all over the place.
That's right.
More than 2,000 people were here this past week. That's just outrageous.
It was. It was. It was neat. It was really neat.
We had the Good Friday service.
That was great. Great.
Man, that was really
great
something.
Great meal, great time, great fellowship. I love the bluegrass.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
the people ate that up.
Yes, they ate the Cracker Barrel and
the
bluegrass.
We had the Porter Wagner show here.
Hee-haw. We did have a lot of fun. Well, as much fun as you can have as a Good Friday service,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I mean, when you're talking about
it was good for us.
Yeah, we need that. I think it makes everybody anticipate the resurrection that much more. I'm glad.
The crowd. It was a huge crowd there, and man, you could hear a pin drop in that place.
Mm-hmm. People were focused. They were focused on the right thing, which is such an answer to prayer to me. For me, like we're in this world where we're just so distracted all the live long day.
Yeah.
And so to come in and then be focused on the right thing, I mean, I pray for that every week. I have to pray that for myself.
Yes,
you know?
I do too.
Especially with your phone flashing me in the eyes all the time. I get distracted.
Oh, golly. Well, I was in Matthew 28.
Yes, sir.
Which
yes,
is
you
one
were.
Of the great resurrection passages.
One of the four?
Yep, one of the four.
I'm so glad you went there. One thing that really stuck out to me, you reminded us, mm-hmm. and I guess you kind of reminded yourself, that with the crucifixion and resurrection, there were two distinct earthquakes.
Yeah,
I thought
there
that was so interesting. I'd never thought about it.
I'd never looked at that or thought about it, too. There was one when Christ died. Of course, that's the one we all really know.
Right.
When the veil of the temple was torn from top to bottom, the earth shook, the rocks were split.
Yes.
That's kind of an interesting turn. The rocks were split. The only thing I can figure from that is that you've got the earth literally opening up.
Yes.
You know, as it does in an earthquake. And then there is the earthquake that evidently surrounded just the area of the tomb. This one in Matthew chapter 27, verse 51, it says the earth shook and the rocks were split. Well, the earth shook. I think
uh-huh.
it's, you know, that was...
Yeah, everybody saw that happen. They felt
know,
it happen.
This was around the tomb area is what I kind of perceived that, around the tomb area. A severe earthquake had occurred, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, came and rolled away the stone. So when he descends and begins to roll away, there's the earthquakes.
Yes. And I so that's God's work. I want to get into that in a second, but this might be a stump both of us here at the table. But when are you going to preach 27 verses 52 and 53 when it says the tombs also were open?
Yeah, yeah.
Many bodies of the saints who'd fallen asleep were raised and coming out of the tombs after his resurrection. They went and appeared to many.
Mm-hmm.
That's a really I love that verse. I don't know the exact meaning of it, but it just seems like his resurrection.
Well,
so
it was a testament to Christ being who he said he was, the
That's
Christ.
Right.
So that when he died, the tombs were open, bodies of the saints. This was a resuscitation, not a resurrection. But it is a picture of what will happen because of the resurrection.
I love that idea that the resurrection power was so much that Christ is raised and a bunch of people around him
mm-hmm.
also spring to life.
Well, this is when he died. When he died, the tombs were open and many bodies of the saints had fallen asleep
okay.
were raised. They came out. After his resurrection, they entered the holy city.
Oh, after that.
Yes.
Okay, so they waited.
And appeared to many. Now the centurion who was there. So they hung around for a while. Evidently, you know, when he died, the tombs were open. Bodies of the saints had come out, were raised. And then after the resurrection, they entered the city and appeared to many.
I love that. That's so,
so
interesting.
So they evidently would die again.
Right. Well,
like this was kind of a Lazarus resuscitation
exactly.
or a daughter of Jairus resuscitation.
Well, and that's why we have to make that distinction because mm-hmm. Jesus never did die again.
No.
He ascended.
Yes.
He was with them for a time.
Yeah.
Was it 40 days or 70 days?
40.
40 days and then goes back to the mount, ascends, and they just watch him into the clouds
yeah.
till they see him no
well,
longer.
The great news of that is in Acts chapter 1 where the angels look and say, why do y'all stand gazing? This
right.
same Jesus who is taken up from you will come again in like manner.
In like manner. I love
so,
that. So, he's going to come right back.
You know, you're looking and gazing. You just need to understand that same Jesus is coming. That's a great Easter message as well.
Let's just have an Easter message every week. Sorry, I'm.
Well, that's funny you say that because I'm headed back to Exodus because we're not even halfway through Exodus, chapter 18, and you're going to come to a clear presentation of the gospel in chapter 18. But I'll just leave it at that.
Okay. Yeah.
To a pagan priest.
whose name happens to be Jethro.
Mm-hmm.
There you go with the mm-hmm. Beverly Hillbillies
well,
again.
Well, you know, Jed's there.
It went really Granny. Well last time. We're going back. What the world's going on here? Are we still on? Is that still working? Okay.
Still working.
Hey, so you just talked about angels, so we got to talk about the angel here. So he rolls away the stone.
Mm-hmm.
There's an earthquake associated with that. You know, it gets everybody's attention. But I loved, I don't know exactly how to approach this, but you talked about the nature of Christ's resurrected body. And he can obviously go through those burial wrappings,
mm-hmm.
you know, because you yeah. made the point they would have broken, yeah. but they yeah, instead sure. they were neatly laid
well,
there.
Well, he didn't, he you know, the back over here in John's gospel.
Oh, okay.
You know, John goes in. So Simon Peter also came following him and entered the tomb, and he saw the linen wrappings lying there. So that's then the face cloth, which had been on his head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Literally, it was folded up and put a little off
yeah.
from the other. So when you take gauze like that, because that's kind of what we would think are linen strips,
uh-huh.
and you wrap that body, now you've got all this blood and all of this bodily fluid. The water, the blood, then you add to it the aloes and everything, would have been on that body.
Dries,
it kind of hardens.
Right.
Not like a plaster of Paris, but it hardens to a degree. And so they look in and they see what...
The shape.
The empty wrappings that were there.
So interesting.
So his body obviously permeated that, just passed through it.
And you made the point, and I thought that was so helpful, that if his body can pass through that, and his body later passes through the walls
mm-hmm.
and the locked
yeah,
door,
yeah.
then of course his body's going to pass through the walls of the tomb as well.
Mm-hmm.
So why was the stone moved? Well, it didn't need to be moved to let him out.
No.
But it was there to let the women
yeah,
see.
Yeah, to let the women and the disciples in to see. And that's why the angel comes and says, come see the place where he was lying. Now, you would think the testimony of an angel. Look, this angel shows up. He's like lightning, his clothes white as snow. Now, you've got these guards in verse 4. The only thing I can compare them to would be Marine guards who guard embassy posts around the world. These are the best of the best, the elite forces that we've got. You would think these guys are well-trained, but they see this angel and they fall down comatose like a dead man.
And terrified, not the women.
But not the women. Why? Because women are made of sterner stuff than
this,
that.
Yes.
So the angel said to the women, so the guards pass out, they faint, they see this angel, and the women come, they see him, and the angel says, look, there's no need for y'all to be afraid. And then he says, he's not here. I know what you're looking for. I know you are looking for Jesus who's been crucified. He's not here. Now, those three things right there. He's been crucified, which implies he was crucified and died.
Yep.
He's not here. He's risen.
Just like he said.
Just like he said. Just like he told you he would do that.
I love that.
And so the angel knows, well, this isn't going to be good enough for a human. You know, so he says, come see the place where he was lying.
Let's talk about that, because you made the point that the place where he was lying, and we see in another gospel account that there's an angel at the head and the foot
mm-hmm. where John's he had gospel. Laid,
and how that is clearly an example of what the mercy seat must have
mm-hmm.
looked like. That's a
yeah.
that's a really big, I don't think most people, a Jew would certainly understood that.
Yeah, when Mary looks in there and she sees an angel here and an angel here, her mind would have immediately gone to the mercy seat. When Peter and John look in there, their mind would, if they saw those two angels
yes.
at the time, they would have thought the exact same thing. That's a picture of the mercy seat right
now,
there.
Yeah, the mercy seat for the uninitiated, I mean, the easiest thing to think of is the Ark of the Covenant that you see in the Indiana Jones movie, which is
yeah.
actually pretty accurate in its depiction. You have the two
You've
cherubim.
You've got the two cherubim that are...
The angels are touching. And so the point there is... that all of that, as Jesus has said multiple times, all of that is pointing ahead to Christ. That's the reason you have a mercy seat.
Yeah,
here it
does.
Is again.
And so here he is, And so the high priest now does not offer sacrifice. The high priest is the sacrifice. Yes.
And the atonement
and
is
complete. He is laid on the mercy seat where his blood pools, is shed,
yes,
right there.
Amen.
And purification, because that's what the writer of Hebrews says.
That's exactly
when
right.
Purification for sins had been made. Let me get over
he
here.
Says
Hebrews
that
chapter
multiple
1.
Times.
Yeah. Great passage. Hebrews chapter 1. When he had made purifications of sin, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become a much better than the angels.
Aha, that's important.
As he has inherited a more excellent name than they.
You got to preach Hebrews. We got to do that.
I would love to preach through Hebrews, but I think it'd take me more time to preach through Hebrews than it will to preach through Exodus.
That's a scary thought. So, there is Hebrews is densely packed. It's not narrative in Hebrews.
No.
It's just kind of theological argument layered on top
Well, let me tell you, Dr. Allen says it's a sermon.
I believe that as well.
He says it's sermon.
It takes about 45, 50 minutes to read through.
Yeah,
you know?
That's about the length of a Charles Stanley sermon. So, there you go. What can you say? Proof enough.
Maybe someday we'll get there. Well, so the point is, Jesus is the perfect. He's the perfect sacrifice. He's the perfect high priest. The mercy seat that was constructed by Moses, you know, Holiab, Eleazar, these guys that are. Why can't I remember the guy's name?
Aaron.
Aholiab and is it Bezalel? The other guy, the master craftsman.
Yeah.
We're
going to
get
okay.
there in Exodus later on. Sorry, I didn't use their Hebrew name. I will next time. These guys constructed the Ark of the Covenant with the mercy seat on top, and all of that is pointing ahead to Christ. So there's a connection there.
Yep,
we're gonna get there eventually. But and then you have, I guess that's pretty much as far as you went in the text. Of course, they departed with fear and great joy. Then they ran to tell the disciples. Of course, there's the evangelistic piece,
mm-hmm.
which you know that's where all of our services end. It's like the evangelism. How will you respond to God's call today? And praise the Lord, we've had a lot of people respond.
Yes, we have. We had people online saved.
Really?
Yeah, we did. We had several
cool.
people online that were saved Sunday. Yeah, and this is an important, and they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, because you're going to see over here in Exodus 18 how Jethro, not the Bodine,
right.
Jethro.
This is the original Jethro.
This is the original Jethro. He rejoiced.
Yes.
There's joy. There's joy with him. He rejoiced. That is always the response of man to the gospel.
Rejoicing. so we should just close by saying how the Lord had such a wonderful victory over this nasty spiritual warfare we had this last weekend. Because that was just really
trying to
something.
Make everybody sick.
I know, everybody. Yeah, I was sick.
You were sick.
My poor daughter spilled boiling hot coffee on herself. She had to go to the hospital. She's fine. Poor Charles.
Charles was sick.
I need to. Have you talked to him yet? I need to give him a call. He was sick. He couldn't sing. I had to do he was supposed to sing the opener. I had to sing that instead.
Yeah.
Say what?
Melissa.
Oh, yeah. Poor Melissa couldn't play clarinet. So Carson was in the hospital.
Carson had emergency surgery.
So praise the Lord, because all those people are either healed or on their way, and then the service went off without a hitch. We worshiped the Lord just like we should.
Yeah,
My poor daughter, she said to me, she said, "Dad, I feel like, is it bad that I'm delaying my baptism because I got hurt?" I said, "Sweetie, in this church, there's people who've been delaying their baptism for 15 years.
Yeah.
You're
going to
be just fine."
Yeah.
A church this size? I thought you'd laugh more at that. I guess
The truth is that's true. That's accurate. There are a lot of folks that need to come and be baptized.
There's much water. What's to prevent
What's
you from being baptized?
Yeah.
We've got at least one more adult baptism coming this Sunday. I'm excited about that.
Hey, we made it. This week, we made it.
We actually
Not on Monday,
made it happen.
But we've done it.
Thanks for being here, Pastor. I do appreciate you taking the time out of your
You can go back to your sitting.
I'm just going to...